What a beautiful sight. Well, today I'm planning to go get this turbocharger swapped out with my buddy. He goes by the name Wild Goose Repair on social media. He's on Instagram, Facebook, TikTok. He's also got a podcast. I listen to it on Spotify called Wrench Jockey Radio. cool dude, and he loves wrenching on trucks, and that's what he does for a living. So I thought, who better to help me out with this turbocharger project? Wild Goose Repair. Check them out. Stay upright somewhere. Yeah, real smooth. full of oil.
Oh, it's not that bad.
Oh, look at it as we get it off. Want to sit it on the bench?
I seen Yogi posted one day, and he was just covered in fucking oil.
Are you going to eat that?
No. So the center section isn't spinning. I'm assuming that clamp is going to hold the center.
Well, that's what I'm thinking. Because they're loose.
Yeah, the center has got to be holding the center. It's just like a big TV.
So odd.
What's it?
It's like...
Cummins guy was right. It's got the single entry.
Yep. Weird.
The whole thing's pretty fucking hot, man.
You know how them old trucks are.
Yeah, no shit. But yeah, this being loose is 100% the reason it took out that turbo. I mean, it...
Even like the oil spewing out of it?
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah, because it moved too much and then it'll spit the seals.
Mm-hmm.
In my opinion. But I'm also half retarded.
Hey, I'd be curious to ask... I'll hold on to this thing and ask Brent about it because I have never seen one of these. It's curious.
It's really curious.
No, didn't seem to have any play, yeah.
No, it doesn't have shaft
play.
It's
weird that it's spitting oil.
Well, it's definitely spitting oil.
Oh, it's spitting oil all day. Twice on Sunday, probably.
Anyway, here's the better turbo.
Woo-hoo.
Bogwiener.
With actually a smaller... exhaust housing, it looks like.
Yeah,
slightly smaller. So your spool up time's gonna be quicker.
Well, that was the whole thing. You know, they sell multiple ones. I was like, well, it's a formula, So I assume it would have the smaller housing since they had lower RPM.
Lower RPM.
And I was like, well, do I want that or do I want? Because she'll rev up, you know, 2200.
Oh yeah.
But. Lance said it didn't matter what one I put on there. It'll work. Yeah. No?
I'm just a bigger fan of Borgs personally. I think Borgs are a better turbo than whole sets. Okay, let's get some studs out of this bitch. Took off right away. And he'd let it run all day, and he'd come back at the end of the day, turn it off, and I mean, he did that for years and years and years. And then one day, he finally came back, or he came in here, and he goes, well, I think I want that truck back on the road again. And we all fell out of our fucking chairs, because we couldn't believe that Gerald was going to get that old FLC on the road again. So I brought it in, started taking it apart, put it back together, welded up some cross members, this, that, and the other. Got the fifth wheel to work again, and all that shit. And, yeah. Good shit. Most fun time.
Yeah. That's kind of how I met you.
Yeah, it is.
I posted it.
Yeah.
Like, that's outside my shop.
I was like, who the fuck is outside the shop taking pictures of Gerald's Freightliner?
Kaiser.
Kaiser. Kaiser.
Yeah.
And then I,
some things you drive by it all the time and see it, and you're like, finally, you're just like, I want to go over and
go there and check it out. Yeah, and then I told you, I was like, give me a minute, and I'll send you some pictures of it next to another one.
Yeah.
That was when Phil Garber's FLC was coming in for a clutch. And so if you go back a couple years in my Instagram, you can see Gerald's set forward axle, Freightliner Classic, with a big bunk next to Phil Graber's set back axle FLC with a small bunk. And these two bays, and that was the cleanest these two bays had ever been, because I was getting that fucking picture, because that was fucking cool. Those are two of the coolest.
I'm going to have to get one with the cab over next door here.
Yeah, you are.
Don't say that.
It's twisting.
That guy, oh, fuck.
Tugging it out.
Oh, I know. Let's see.
That's what I was thinking.
Yeah, that guy was just too angry, man.
Should have left him alone. I would have just run the thread cleaner down the fucker. Could have been that fucked up.
We got new studs, so may as well do new studs.
Right on the tit. It's gonna snap right off.
Crank that up to D.
To D?
Yeah, to D.
I just gave it the D.
Just gave it the D, baby.
If you want a tap socket, it's going to be on the right-hand side in the red box. I should have one that big. Don't quote me.
No.
Just get a 12.38 socket then.
Heard this song?
I don't think so. Fucker.
Well, I welded it on there nice and good because I just broke the study further.
Yeah, it looked like it. Looks like it's in there a little more.
Never run no faster than the big old wizard round. Oh, okay, five.
Don't need that.
Did you just kill that guy?
I welded it on good enough because there's stud in there.
Time to get the drill bits.
Yep.
55.
throw a rag around that drain tube?
Oh, hey, yeah, do that. Grab me a rag.
I was just looking at that. Goose just did a
in frame on this.
Made her back home successfully. Here's the finished product. Had to make a new oil supply line. Was able to reuse the old drain line. And I got a new boot. Mismatched clamps, unfortunately. But I think it's a lot better with this turbo on there. It's got the good whistle and it spools up good. I noticed in my mirror that there's a lot less black smoke when rowing the gears. So I'd say it was a success. The odds are that that guy I had working on the truck is going to end up with my 79 4300. And he's going to be able to fix it up and get it running. As opposed to it just sitting and rotting away, waiting for me to build money to work on it and work on this one. So, I think in the last video I mentioned that I hadn't heard from the BMV. Well, I got a letter this week, like the day after I posted that video. And the letter said I didn't fill out one of the forms all the way. So I filled the form out and mailed it back. So, hopefully get that title in another month. Still got something leaking oil. Put that on the list. While we were there, I had him look at my clutch because I got no clutch brake. And he said, there's a reman sticker on this transmission. It was reman in 1992. And there's a cheap clutch in it. A cheap Chinese clutch, he said. And he said adjusting that he could damage it by adjusting it because he has to use like an air hammer or something on it. And he could put a bigger clutch brake in it, he said, a thicker one. But we're going to save that for another day. That carrier bearing we discovered needs replaced. So, to do the carrier bearing and the transmission output shaft has a seal that's leaking. So we're probably going to do all that all at the same time. And unfortunately, we'll have to drop the exhaust out to do all that. It's like a K-style Y-pipe. So basically, getting all this done is going to snowball into a big project. Probably have to replace the exhaust, which, I mean, it needs it anyway. It's got holes all over the place. And this valve back here is leaking. So that's on the list. But I am happy with my new turbo purchase and I need to save some more money back up. So